Is there a right way to upload your videos to YouTube?
There is, and there's definitely a wrong way, so we're going to talk about that today.
How to upload videos properly on... Oh, wait, I had it. Hold it. YouTube.
There is a way to do it properly, and there's a way that you don't want to do it. Hopefully, this is actually just going to be a simple, quick video, because I'm going to demonstrate how to do it. What you don't want to do is upload it to public. So let me bring over my...
Oh, you don't?
Yeah, don't upload it public, and I'll explain.
Don't we want the public to see it?
Yes, but not
eventually.
Yet. All right, so we're here on YouTube. When you upload a video, a little screen pops up.
Yes, and this looks familiar.
This little box right here.
Okay.
If it says public, that's a bad thing. You want to go into your default settings and make sure it's unlisted or private. And I actually recommend private. In fact, I'll show you.
Because now, it's only fair that we should say that you're building a case here.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when you say don't put it public, you mean for the moment.
Correct.
Right.
But when you upload it, you don't want it to go to public right then.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. And there's a reason for that.
Huge reason.
Yes.
Huge reason.
Okay.
So I'll get to the reason. Let me just show you how to change your default upload settings. I've got a shortcut right here. I'll just go into my video manager.
TubeBuddy.
Quick little promotion by TubeBuddy.
Okay.
Let's see. If I come down here to channel. Hey there. That's you.
There we are.
And then right here, upload defaults. And right here, the top one, I can change that to private. So if it says public, you can set it to unlisted, or I'm going to even recommend private. And I will.
Because unlisted is still public, it's just not listed. So someone could stumble upon it or even go to your channel.
And that's not the problem.
Right,
not yet. Talk about the problem.
Yes, yet.
But the great advantage to private is when it's private, you can then schedule it
for
when
it
goes public.
Okay.
So now that I've.
And there's a reason for that, for scheduling.
Yeah,
as opposed to just doing it right now.
Yeah, big one is convenience. You can do things ahead of time. But now that we've got the demonstration out of the way of how to change your defaults and when you upload it,
okay.
Here's the problem. If it's set to public and you upload, so a video is uploading and it goes public, that becomes the start date. Even if you then change it to unlisted or to private, it's already gone public once. And so then if you launch it a couple days later, it will look back, ooh, the previous 48 hours, it's had no views, so this is a bad video.
And that's gonna count. I see, yeah.
So it could be hugely detrimental to your channel.
Now tell us why, and maybe this is another video, which I know it is, but why do we care if we're scheduling it anyway? What's the ultimate reason, you know, to schedule it 4 days later? Why wouldn't I want to start it today?
Well, in the case of today, how many videos are we filming?
20.
20 videos. We're filming 20 episodes today. We're obviously not going to release them all in one day. We're going to start editing those, get them into the queue, and we're going to launch them just one per day. When you have consistent content like that that's regular, you'll get the results that you want on YouTube. YouTube likes that consistency. Your followers like that consistency. So that's why we want to use that scheduling tool. But even if I'm doing it manually, and I'm just going to manually go in and, okay, now it's ready and I'll change it to public, if it's already been public before, your video just gets off on the wrong foot. You're hoping to get a whole bunch of views, but YouTube might have already sent out the email. And you've already got all this history. Oh, this video isn't a new one. If people are going to your channel to look for new videos, it won't show up as a new video. It'll show up according to the first date.
Ah.
So, I mean, when we film an entire month's worth of these videos in one day, this video might not actually go live for, you know, many weeks. And if I accidentally uploaded it to public, and yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I see. So basically what Nate is saying is that every time that he's talking about uploading things onto YouTube, changing settings, doing whatever, he's describing all of that in the context of this process of shooting a lot of content in one day and then spacing it out, scheduling it for a month at a time, as opposed to just a one-off, hey, I've got a video I want to upload to YouTube. How do I upload it? Well, upload it however you want, you freak. What were... Actually, Nate didn't say that. That's just me. But I would say even just as a regular good practice, upload it private.
Mm-hmm.
Because you and at the moment, you might not actually want it to go live right then.
Yeah, let me show you some other things that you can do or that you want to do on your video before it goes live
as
well.
And the freak thing. You're not a freak. You're a wonderful person.
He uses that term as a term of
endearment. Oh, you freak. I love all right, you.
So here's some videos of mine that are still private. You see the lock there. Yeah. These are going to go live soon once they're approved. In fact, you know what?
What?
There's a video that can go live today.
Ooh.
Okay, this video, you see it was uploaded back on June 12th, mm-hmm. but it wasn't uploaded public. And so that date will reset. If I come in here to edit this video, and I'm going to, let me show you some things that I've done that I want to make sure I've got a clean title in there that has the search phrase. This is the leaf topic that I want. I've got my description all set up the way that I want. And then I've got the keywords that I've chosen. This video has been transcribed. I've had my assistant go through and clean up the grammar in the automatic transcription and make sure all the spelling is correct in there.
Wow.
We've added our cards. I'll even show you, we've added the end screen. In fact, if my team hasn't, then we will add it. But yep, it's been added. So the last 20 seconds, there'll be this subscribe button that appears right here. And you know, they'll have another video there. So these are all the different things that you wanna make sure are set up on your video before you make it public. So I'm going to come back here to the info and settings tab. And now I can manually go to public, or I can, let me just show you schedule. I'll schedule it to go live in like 5 minutes. So the time that we are filming this is 10:50 a.m. Today's the 18th. It gives me a warning because 10:30 was in the past. I'll have to do it for 11. So if I set it to go live at 11 a.m., I just have to come up here and actually hit this publish. There we go. Okay, so now it says saved changes. So at 11 a.m.
today,
it'll go public.
And that's, now do you research at all time zones and ideal times? Is there, you know, for a specific topic or a channel, or, you know, is it beneficial to look at that?
Because I've got viewers all over the globe, and different channels will have different viewers in different time zones.
Right.
So it's like,
yeah.
How do you know which one to go after? I basically go after, most of my viewers are in the United States, so I post it in the morning in United States time zones.
Then it's just, it may or may not matter.
You might find the evening is the best for you, or you might find that if you post just on weekdays, or maybe weekends, or like there's extra special time on Saturday mornings. But I've just not stressed about that one.
I'm sure it's just a pipe dream, but it'd be great if I just knew that there were people just sitting in front of their screen, just waiting for the release of my new video.
If you post consistently at the same time every day, then you will have
probably
that.
Probably will get that.
If people know at 9 a.m. Scott's going to have a new video up, then they'll be waiting. Whatever time zone it is for them, they'll know that time. Ooh, is Scott's video up? What? It's 9:01. Where is it? Oh, there it is. They'll do that. I know that because I do that on some channels.
Well, I'll have to
maybe not to the minute, but I'm like, they haven't posted a video this morning. What's up?
Yeah, right. No, and my content will have to be really, really good for somebody to wake up that early to care.
So what do you guys think? Is this, are you going to upload to public anymore?
No.
I hope not.
The answer is no.
But make sure you subscribe.
The answer
is yes.
That's
definitely something you want to do. Hit that bell and we'll make more videos like this. Does that sound